There was a great article that I've been waiting for in the New England Journal about antisense drugs. You know, a lot of folks are going to be saying, what the heck is LP little A? And maybe I don't really have any interest in that. I don't have it. If you're thinking you don't have it, you might want to just make sure, because LP little A has been one of those dirty little secrets that docs didn't share. Most docs don't even know about it. And it's a known, actually well-known cardiovascular risk. It is a variation of LDL. And it's actually an LDL, which for some reason, we can talk about a little bit later, attracts oxidized LDL. Many people felt like we didn't have an effective treatment. So the standard response was, well, you know what? We don't have anything to treat it with, any drugs or anything, so let's just not even talk about it. For example, I think it was the Mayo cardiology medical director said, well, let's just give them statins. Well, statins don't really help. LP little a is an issue. And it started to hit what we call prime time. I've got several different videos on LP little a hitting prime time. When Bob Harper had his heart attack, he shared, yep, it was due to LP little a. So making a lot of progress in that space. So that's one reason that you may want to know about it. Most of us have never been tested for it. Another reason is the prevalence is really high. It's between 20 and 40%, depending on what you want to use for a cut point in terms of levels. Now, we have used niacin in the past. And again, we'll get into a little bit more about all of that as we get into that part of the presentation. So to the LP little a, as I mentioned, LP little a has not been covered very well. Again, docs felt like there wasn't much they could do for it, and so they just didn't even test for it and didn't talk to patients about it, didn't learn about it. And then Bob Harper had a heart attack a couple of years ago. He's on TV, and he's a celebrity known for being in shape. And he had a heart attack? Yeah, he did. And he announced later it was due to LP little a. Now, what is LP little a? As I said before, it's something that we've known about, at least in the research areas, even if the standard medical community didn't know what to do with it. It's a variation of LDL. And if you look at it, here's maybe the geeky part, the biochemistry part. This whole image is what we call a lipoprotein. It is a picture of an LDL. The lipoprotein is a protein that takes cholesterol and forms it into a ball so it doesn't form a big clot or embolus in the bloodstream, which is mostly water, over 90% water. Now, this pink reddish part represents, it's called ApoB. It is the protein that holds that cholesterol together. Now, what's different about LP little a from other LDL is this Kringle repeats section. It looks like the genetics on this one got a little bit confused and created a long chain that's hanging off. We used to think that that little chain maybe actually hooked into the endothelium. Maybe that was the cause of the inflammation. But more recently, we're finding out something very different. For some reason, this ApoB protein appears to attract and hold oxidized LDL. I know a lot of people on our channel watch Ivor Cummins as well. Ivor Cummins has got a couple of good videos on the importance of oxidized LDL. That appears to be the bad actor in terms of inflammation and getting in and forming plaque. So back to that original image, how have we treated LP little a in the past? As I mentioned, Mayo said, well, you know, just give them statins. We know that doesn't help LP little a any, but we think it'll help LDL in general. Well, that's one way, and clearly it's got its merits. The Europeans have always given niacin. I've always given niacin. A lot of docs that I know use niacin instead. Niacin will reliably, most reliably, I'd say what, 60 to 80% of the time, niacin will give us a 30% drop in LP little a. Again, Europeans use it. The Americans, you know, just sometimes drive me crazy, as you know. Apheresis, that's where it's like dialysis, where you take the blood out of the body, you filter it, and you put it back in. That does work, but it only lasts for 2 weeks, and the body makes LP little a again. So that's not a great solution. ApoA, antisense oligonucleotide. That sounds very technical. That's actually what we're going to talk about today. That was what the New England Journal article is about. But what is it? So here's the thing. If you go back to the genetic processes, the process for making a protein starts with DNA transcribed. I can't remember there's some differentiate on that. Anyhow, DNA is turned into a mirror RNA image. And then the RNA image is used to translate into an amino acid sequence. So the antisense drugs actually fit into this messenger RNA that's going to be used to make that amino acid protein sequence for the ApoB to make Lp(a). That drug then is made, and it just sort of blocks that next process. So hopefully that helps you begin to get a little bit of understanding about what antisense oligonucleotides means. So antisense means it's on the other side. It's the mirror image. And it's an oligo, meaning a small batch. And again, it blocks that next process. I've also done videos on where L-carnitine has been shown to help as well. I think we can all agree, unless you've got like world-class level Lp(a), you might want to continue to focus more on things like niacin, maybe carnitine, because the antisense drugs were working very well, getting 80% impact, and that's unprecedented. I have seen one patient get an 80% impact from niacin. And this was a patient that really, you know, her Lp(a) numbers were like 70 or 80, and those weren't really bad numbers. On the other end of the spectrum, we've got folks like Joe Riley. You remember Joe did a video with us, maybe a couple of videos. And the highest number I've ever seen, it was like over 800, maybe over 1,000. Joe also shared with us that he'd had the aortic valve calcification that you get with this. So again, now that's somebody that would clearly focus on making sure that we get the access to the antisense drugs as soon as possible. This is that one of those articles on carnitine. Now, let's get back to the New England Journal article itself. As you see here, it was New England Journal, January 16th of this year, 2020. Lp(a) reduction in persons with cardiovascular disease. Semikas is the lead author. And as I said, this is a big deal. It's something that many of us have been waiting for quite a while. And the methods, they just did a double-blind, randomized control trial. They use different levels, different amounts, 20, 40, or 60 milligrams of the antisense drug, AKCEA, ApoA, LRX. You know, again, no need to try to remember any of that. Up to 80% reduction. So reliably, but that was at the higher dosage levels. So obviously, I've got a lot of patients that are very smart. They keep an eye on this. I don't remember if it was one of my patients or Nutranuva, somebody I've talked with a few times out in, I think, LA. Anyhow, somebody alerted me to this, and it's, again, a great article, a great development, and whoever alerted me, thank you for letting me know. One of the reasons I don't remember is that I've gotten emails and calls from multiple of my Lp(a) patients, and they're all asking the same question. How can I get into the next study? How can I get access to this? Again, it's not maybe overused a phrase. Getting this medication is not quite ready for prime time. They're going to need to do a little bit more work on it. And again, there's a lot of demand. One of the things that you're going to see happening is now the doctors in standard medicine, maybe even your own cardiologist, will actually start testing for Lp(a) because we're beginning to see we've got a treatment now. Like some of the other treatments, like PCSK9s, for example, I expect these things are going to be maybe tens of thousands of dollars per year until the patent breaks and or there's significant competition in the area. I will tell you, for, again, the majority of my Lp(a) patients, niacin has done a great job. So it's a great thing. It's a wonderful thing to happen. It's going to complicate things a little bit more because now there's going to be the question of, okay, is this worth the new drug and its added expense, or do we want to continue to work with the old school stuff, niacin, carnitine, stuff like that? Let me see if there was anything else to cover on that. No, I just mentioned the cardiovascular disease, the calcific aortic valve stenosis, which we mentioned that Joe shared with us, and the comment that the hook, the Kringle repeats going into the endothelium. It's more of the fact that for some reason, LP little a tends to attract oxidized LDL. Now here's the images. Here's what happened. Again, for the higher dosages, you were getting 80% decrease in LP little a. Really, really impressive and unprecedented. Basically showed the impact on the other LDL, ApoB, stuff like that, HDL, triglycerides, as you see, very minimal impact on the other stuff, just focused on LP little a. And by the way, very few side effects. The major side effect was irritation of the injection site.
If plaque is the number one cause of heart attack, stroke, dementia, blindness, kidney disease, you'd think we'd know how to evaluate it, screen for it, wouldn't you? Unfortunately, the state of the art right now is a guess, and a bad one at that, Framingham. The most common thing that you do is you say, well, hey, doc, why don't we do a stress test? They don't work either. Then you go into the cath lab and get a definitive test, but that involves getting a needle in the groin. It just goes downhill from there. Now, there are better ways. Take a look at our plaque evaluation course. Click the link below.